The 26th of January can be a sad day for Aboriginal Australia. It's a day of reflection as we think about the past and celebrate our survival. But for John Patten, grandson of the legendary Jack Patten, it's a day to remember the powerful legacy left by him and other campaigners involved in the 1938 National Day of Mourning. Danny Teece-Johnson has more.
Now and then you meet someone who comes across as a wise old man, a keeper of knowledge and is a salt of the earth. Meet John Patten. He has dedicated his life to his culture and his grandfather's significant legacy.
I never had a chance to meet my grandfather, but what I do know is that he was a great man. He was a great public speaker, Jack Patten. He was the person who organised and led the Day of Mourning based on an idea of William Cooper's. The Day of Mourning was held at Elizabeth Street in Sydney on the sesquicentenary of the white invasion of Australia, 150 years. And Jack seized upon the idea that Aboriginal people, we didn't have the rights that other people did. So he wrote up a plan, a 10-point plan for citizens' rights.
So 150 years after the First Fleet invaded the beautiful Eora Nation, the first National Day of Mourning was held. Our people were not going to sit idle anymore.
The idea was originally to have the Day of Mourning held at the Sydney Town Hall, but they were knocked back. So that was quite early on in the piece. So what they did was approach the management of Australia Hall, and they had no problem. So it was held in Elizabeth Street. And it's an interesting place, Elizabeth Hall as well, because in 1998, all the descendants of those people that fought in 1938, William Cooper, Jack Patten, Margaret Tucker, Bill Ferguson, the descendants all came together and we fought for that building to be preserved to ensure that what they had achieved on that day could be preserved for future generations. So I'm very proud of my grandfather and all those people.
The legacy and memory of those who organised and were involved in the 1938 Day of Mourning drives John today. He says we know who Malcolm X is, but we don't know enough about our own heroes, and that needs to change.
One of the things that I'm most passionate about is the fact that people like Jack Patten, Margaret Tucker, Geraldine Briggs, Lyle Roberts, these people fought very hard for our rights to be on that equal footing with everyone else. But here in this country, we don't know who those people are. We know who Malcolm X was, we know who Martin Luther King was, but we don't know who those people are that fought so hard for us. That needs to be taught better in schools. It needs to be understood and appreciated.
So as we prepare to celebrate our survival on the 26th of January, keep a place in your hearts and minds for those who made a stand. We will be forever taller for it. Always was, always will be. Danny Teece-Johnson for NITV News.